The Texas defense made some huge plays on Saturday, but it wasn't enough to stop Geno Smith and the Mountaineers. Here to talk about what went wrong and what went right is Manny Diaz. Thank you so much for being here, Coach.
My pleasure.
An easy place to start, Alex Okafor. Mac Brown said on Rewind Monday that here is a guy who gets better every week, as scary as that thought may be. Two sacks, two forced fumbles, and a blocked field goal. Can you talk about his contribution on the field?
Well, it's exciting to see as a coach. You want your best players to be your best players. You want your seniors to lead your football team. And Alex is a guy that has gotten better week in, week out. I remember this time last year I was over here talking about why he can't get a sack. And Oscar Giles has done a great job investing in him, just working on getting better. Alex tries to master his trade. And we talked about, we thought we might have a couple chances to get back there by the quarterback. We talked about not just wanting to sack him, but be violent around the quarterback, be violent at the football, which was to cause some ball disruption plays because they were not going to turn it over on their own. So those were big plays in the game.
Last week you talked about how impressed you were with Kendall Thompson's play at Oklahoma State. What can you say about that young guy this week?
I'm telling you, Kendall played maybe 10 or 12 plays at Oklahoma State. He played about all the plays this past game. And I don't know if people can appreciate how hard it is for a guy. That's really his first ever college game when you're playing an offense like that. So there'll be some things we have to clean up. But it's when you see plays like this, the flashes, that means that he can do it. It'd be great for his confidence. Things we can work on now for the coming week to get better. But it gave me a lot of excitement to see Kendall. Steve Edmund made a couple plays. And those young guys, true sophomores playing their first games, they're going to get a lot better.
We didn't see Malcolm Brown in on offense, but we saw the other Malcolm Brown in on defense. What did you like from that freshman's play?
Well, we've been excited about Malcolm since he stepped foot on campus, and he's been growing. Bo Davis has really developed him from, he was showing up in individual drills, getting better and better and better, started doing some really nice things in team drills, and you saw again last night a guy that can make a play on the inside. He's big, he's strong, but he's got a great quickness and change of direction. Comes off right here on a stunt, makes a tackle in the backfield, tackle for loss. So, again, things that will just help his confidence so much. Still a lot of technique, things he's got to clean up, but he can be in the mix now and just add to our depth. You can never have too many guys at that position.
West Virginia was perfect on the night on fourth down conversions, 5 for 5, and yet they were 3 for 12 on third downs. How did those fourth down conversions affect the game?
It was the game. With what we did on downs 1 through 3, Geno Smith threw for 120 yards. Not when you take away the screens, he threw for 120 yards on first, second, and third down. And was about 50% completion percentage. But those are shocking numbers for a player of his caliber. They got us on fourth down. And fourth down was a difference in the ball game. Sometimes it was execution. He put the throw on the money. We always had two guys on number one, and he made a nice job making it happen. Part of it was field position. I think the secret assassin in this game was that they got the ball in four down territory at times, or one first down away from being in four down territory. And then, you have to credit them. They had the confidence in that guy to go for it on fourth down. We might have been our worst by blocking a field goal and blocking a punt. We may have convinced them to say, you know what, we might as well just go for it on fourth down. And ultimately, if we could have stopped one of those, two of those, and absolutely all three, because 21 points on drives they converted fourth down, so that was the difference in the ball game.
Everybody knew about Geno Smith, Tavon Austin, Stedman Bailey going into this game. But Andrew Bowie, did he surprise you?
Well, we obviously gave up more run yards than we wanted to, but when you're going to take five, you only have 11. And when you're going to take five, so you can put two on number one, two on number three, and then one guy's on the other guy, you're only going to have six left for Bowie. Bowie had 140 yards going into the last drive of the game, including that 30-yard run right there on the first drive, which we had some mistakes on. If we could have stopped the fourth downs and he had all those yards, we'd have won the football game by a comfortable margin. So in a way, we're disappointed in the way that we played some of those run plays, but we felt like that was still part of the winning formula. The yards he got in the last drive, I think he ran for about 70 yards in the last drive. That was unacceptable. We had a hard time switching back from what we had practiced all week, what we had played for 3.5 quarters, to switching back to now we have to go stop the run, change the way that we're fitting it, change the way we're covering him, play one-on-one. Our guys were just slow, and that's my responsibility of understanding that we're not playing in the second quarter anymore. It's changed, and then by the time we got it, it was too late.
Coach Brown said on Rewind Monday that Stedman Bailey was double covered on at least one of his scores. What made him so hard to contain?
Well, what they do is schematically, they have a run play and a pass play called at the same time. Okay, so what you're trying to do is you're trying to get double coverage on the wideouts, but the safeties on the inside have to read run pass. And from peewee to pro football, you teach them to read the end man on the line of scrimmage, the offensive lineman. When the offensive lineman goes down the field, that makes it look like run, which means you want to leave, the Bailey by himself. They were doing that and still throwing the ball. So they were making a key a little bit tough on the safeties. That being said, especially on the last one, we just have to execute better. When we have two on one, we can't put three guys on one. That's about the best we can do. But that's why Bailey's a great player, and that's why Geno Smith's a great player.
Battle was the word every one of your guys used when I talked to them after the game, Kenny Vaccaro being one of those guys. And after the game, he took to Twitter and he said this. He said, "Not going to give a Tebow speech, but I will do everything I can to make sure our team fixes what needs to be fixed. Don't have many more left." One of your stars on defense, definitely adhering to that 24-hour rule that you have. When you look ahead to OU, what is most important for you guys to fix?
Well, we just have to keep getting better. I mean, I think that's the thing. There's a lot of positive things. When our players came in, they felt badly, as they should when you lose a game. We all felt very bad after the game. But when you come back in and you watch the tape, there's a lot of really good stuff there on the tape. And when you realize against a great offensive football team. So what you do is, as you do every week, you take the good and you try and fix the things that you're not proud of and you're trying to get better. Some guys are just getting better on their own. I mean, Mykel Thompson, another true sophomore, was outstanding against a great offensive football team. So those type of performances, you keep building on that, and that's how you get real confidence. You get real confidence by accomplishing things in actual games and not by talking about it. So we'll follow Kenny's leadership. Guys like Alex Okafor, we only have two seniors. We have to rely on them. But I'm very excited about where we're at and going into this OU game.
We saw what Oklahoma did to Texas Tech this weekend. What is the biggest challenge that the Sooners present to you?
Well, number one, it's obviously a great game, great atmosphere. You've got to do a great job of handling their tempo. They're gonna attack at a relentless pace. So it's a challenge to get lined up, communication, and then you got to go play them. You know, and then the ball actually gets snapped. So great quarterback. You know, Landry Jones has been as consistently good at a quarterback as has been in the country the last two or three years. So anytime, as we always talk about, anytime the guy that holds the ball every play is a great player, they have a chance to make something happen. So from the run game to the pass game, it'll be a great stress on all levels of our defense, but it's a challenge that we're really excited and looking forward to.
Well, you can bet we'll be talking Texas OU all week. Thank you so much, Coach Diaz.
My pleasure.